Cass.
Hey, Mitch.
Did you tell her yet?
Not yet.
When are you gonna tell her?
I'll tell her.
When?
I'll tell her.
Tell who what? Tell who what?
Nothing, Grandma.
You two ain't been showering without a raincoat.
Grandma.
Your mama find out, she'll clip your wings and nip his bud.
Grandma.
I almost forgot these.
Oh, good.
Oh, Claire. These are hideous.
Oh, you sweet talker. Never know why tourists go for this junk. Oh. This is more than we agreed.
You go on, take it.
No favors.
How many guests you got this weekend? When was the last time you filled your room?
Adorable.
I was going to Bessie's for...
How much are these?
Five each for lunch. You join me for a bite.
$5? Oh, gracious.
I could come out Thursday.
Five each. Is there a discount for seniors?
No. Clean out your septic tank.
That's not necessary. Oh, I should think for seniors.
Claire, it's no problem.
Citizens. Thanks. Listen, I'm on a fixed income.
Okay. Look, you buy one, give you one free.
Give me four. That's 2 for $10, 2 gratis. And ring up a fifth of Johnny Red while you're at it.
For they are jolly good ladies. For they are jolly good ladies. For they are jolly good ladies. Which nobody can deny. Make a wish. What'd you wish for?
Hot sex. What'd you wish for?
It's not my birthday. Cassie.
Can't tell.
You want to cut the cake, honey?
I'm on a diet.
You know what I got in the mail today? My first Social Security check. I tore it up.
Ruth, we're in no position.
I don't want that money.
No, give it to me. We have bills.
I don't want that money.
We can fix the car. We can buy
Mom.
New... She doesn't want the money. You don't need to diet.
Look at these boobs.
What's wrong with your boobs, your breasts?
They're humongous. Like everything I eat lands on my chest.
Your daddy had one hell of an appetite at 16. Blake ate like a horse.
Besides, you're growing, you're blossoming, you're ripening. Jesus, Mom, I'm not a fruit tree. They're just boobs. Mm. I hate them. They're too big. I don't even want to talk about this anymore.
You know what Amos and I do on Friday night? We talk about lobsters.
Happy birthday, Grandma.
Tobacco, I was out, thank you.
Ta-da!
Rock candy.
Dig deeper.
God. Grandma.
Ruth.
Yellow, red, blue, green.
Ruth.
Oh, now magenta.
Keep your garters on. It's just a joke.
Cassie.
Sweetheart.
Your dad gave that to me on our first anniversary. Try it on.
Like a refugee from Woodstock. What is this?
It's my present from Mom.
Oh. Evening, Mrs. Wellesley. Ma'am.
Mitch.
Mitch.
Mitch's mom invited me over for cheesecake.
I thought you were on a diet.
Aren't you gonna wear it? I'm not cold.
Yet?
65.
It's disgusting. I don't feel old. Hell, sometimes I could be 30. Maybe something's wrong with me, but I still want. I like men. You know how long it's been since someone squeezed my knee? Maybe something is wrong with me, but I want. You think there's something wrong with me, Claire?
What?
I'll clear the table.
That diet. Fine. I'd like to talk.
Me too.
You know I love you.
Whenever you start like that, you end up grounding me.
Is there some reason why I should ground you? In the next few years, you'll be making big decisions about life, love, and sex.
Not sex again.
Sex is very important.
I know.
What do you mean you know? Being an adult means being in control of situations and of yourself. Do you understand? Where are you going? I'm not finished.
Mom, you're never finished.
What's going on?
Please, on the beach. Come on. Come on.
Won't hurt you. Are you all right? Get a blanket. Go on. Hurry up. Prettier fingernails than I've got. Not the average bum on the beach, are you?
Where is this?
Peeler Point, Maine. It's about 2 miles from town.
Busy place? Thank you.
Now, how'd you end up on our beach?
Were you swimming? Did you fall off a boat?
I don't remember.
Oh, that's okay. I've had a couple of lost weekends myself. What's your name?
I don't remember.
Amnesia.
I'm calling the police.
Mom.
If he's sick, he belongs in a hospital.
Oh, I hate the smell of hospitals.
He hates the smell of hospitals.
He could stay in the guest room.
Oh, those are for paying customers.
We haven't had a paying customer in 3 weeks.
He could stay in the attic.
Oh, I like attics.
He likes attics.
Oh, this is ridiculous. I will not have a strange man staying in my house.
Claire, this is not your house. This is my house.
I can work. Fix things. Handyman.
We can't pay much.
Room and board.
We don't need a handyman.
Deal.
Ruth!
Deal!
Ruth, we don't need a handyman!
Now we need a handyman.
Morning, Amos.
I got a winner here.
Morning, Amos.
How do you, Emma?
Jesus Christ, on a bicycle, Amos. Why don't you look where you're going?
Ruthie, you look different.
What is that, Amos?
Jezebel died.
I'm sorry to hear that. Got Ahab a new girlfriend, huh?
Nothing lonelier than that lonely old widower.
Oh, they fight in a court?
Hard to say. Where have you been lately?
Busy.
Fixing up the place? Need help?
No. We got ourselves a man.
A man?
Handyman.
Someone I know. Some kid.
Old enough.
Part-time? Summer work?
Full-time. I think we can keep him busy through the winter.
How about a bite at Bessie's? A nip at my place?
It all up herself.
Reminds me of Kurt Weill. With a touch of Philip Glass.
Exactly. That's exactly what I'm going for. Except a little more. I mean, height is important, too. Someday, I'm going to do an entire concert on a tightrope. That would be the ultimate post-nuclear statement.
Yes. I see what you mean.
Why don't you play the Tchaikovsky, honey?
I don't want to play the Tchaikovsky.
You play it so beautifully. I hate the Tchaikovsky.
Full of piss and vinegar. Just like my son, her daddy.
Where is daddy, if you don't mind my asking?
And if we do?
Honestly, Claire, Sometimes she has a tongue like a nettle.
Sharp, but sweet.
My husband was Senator Blake Wellesley.
Sorry. I read his biography.
That was an unauthorized, malicious piece of fiction.
I saw him once at a rally somewhere or other, protesting something.
Funny how a man with amnesia can remember all that.
We have to come up with a name for you. I mean, before you remember your real name.
John.
Oh, boring. It has to be something with personality, like Maximilian.
Fred. Bob.
Frank.
Alexander. How about Adam? Like in the Garden of Eden?
Certainly have the garden.
And we're just as ruthless with snakes.
What it closed at, I want 3,000 more shares. Just do it, Susumu. Domo. How did it go?
Fine.
Any problems?
No.
And afterwards, you threw it overboard?
Yes. Essentially.
I finished that report.
Essentially.
Well, actually, Julius got a little carried away, and he went over the rail into the water.
Did you see the body?
Well, we're 3 miles out. The water was freezing. He was dead on his feet.
Go find the body.
Alex, he's dead now. You can relax.
Don't you tell me what I can do. But what if the body doesn't wash up on the shore? I mean, what if it goes out to sea? Well, Julius, how soon can you be ready for another little trip? Fine.
Alex, this is insane.
I want proof that he's dead. Do you understand me? You give me proof that he's dead, or you're dead.
Get those.
In the attic, not a very good fit, I'm afraid.
They're Blake's. Take them off. Not now, I mean. You are not to wear Blake's clothes.
I'm sorry. I wasn't thinking. You see, mine are still damp. I forgot to pack a change.
Well, I'll get you some clothes. Just don't wear his clothes.
Not a morning person, are we?
Thank you.
No. Randolph Hyatt. What, you a guest?
Not a relative.
No, I'm the handyman.
Randolph.
Claire, this person says he's your handyman.
It's a long story, Randolph. Why did you come?
To clean out your septic tank. You need a thorough flushing.
Adam will take care of that.
Well, what about the ceiling, the widow's walk? I can fix the walk.
Adam will take care of it.
Adam. Fine.
Oh, I do appreciate...
I didn't expect this from you, Claire. Not after all these years.
Who was that?
I thought you were going to fix the drain.
The pipes are bad. You need new pipes.
We can't afford that. What about the septic tank?
Well, you can't flush it until you get new pipes.
This is ridiculous.
I once assisted in the renovation of an 18th century Shropshire Inn. It had a plumbing system much the same as yours, but... on a much grander scale, of course, but basically the same design. Now, the owner, despite my pleas, refused to install new pipes. So, when that tank was flushed, those old pipes exploded at almost every joint. Well, you imagine all that human waste seeping down behind the walls into the very foundations. It costs thousands just to clean it up enough to start over again.
The kitchen faucet's slow now.
New pipes.
We can't afford new pipes.
We need to advertise more.
You need more to advertise.
Thank you, Mr. Marriott.
You need to paint the rooms. Fix that widow's walk. Serve sherry up there. Hang pictures. Throw antique quilts on the beds.
We can't afford antique quilts.
You don't have to. They look old enough as it is. Just call them antique. Call everything antique. What do you charge a night?
45, including coffee cake.
85, 90.
90 in Peeler Point.
You do it right, they'll ante up 200.
Wow.
Say the sheets are sewn by hand. The doilies brought over from Ireland by your great-grandmother. You grind fresh cinnamon every morning for the coffee cake.
We don't grind.
You don't have to. You just have to make them think you do.
Whatever you are, it's certainly not a pillar of society.
Maybe.
Pieces, please.
I beg your pardon?
Littler pieces, please.
There are big pieces, medium-sized pieces, and little pieces. That is a big piece.
Well, I want littler pieces.
Perhaps you would like to do it yourself.
Are you the handyman or not?
All the beaches in all the world.
What?
As my lady wishes.
When you're done, you can fix the porch step.
Oh. Thank you very much.
A sailor, a
asleep in the sun.
Bum, bum.
Woke to find that his fly was undone. He remarked with a smile, "Oh Lord, a sundial, and now it's a quarter past one."
Aye, boys, fly, boys, and now it's a quarter past one.
Oh, fuck!
Told you to watch those sterns. You know, I'm taking a risk on you. It isn't the kind of world anymore that you... that a stranger in.
After the war, I got into a fight in a bar in Rangoon. An American saved my life. We became great pals, buddies. Saw a lot of the world together. Then we went our different ways. He went to New York. Got involved with a certain family. About a month ago, I had a call. He was in trouble. He wanted out. He needed help. He had saved my life.
And where is he now?
Safe.
And what about you?
I think you can assume I'm safe, too.
Always in
my room.
How
could you bring this trash into my house? His women. How could you do that?
I didn't want anyone else to check it out.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Living only with women, you begin to feel like a nun.
You should go find yourself a handsome young thing. And live in sin.
Leave Claire alone?
She has Cassie.
Oh, Cassie will be leaving in a few years. No. Claire needs me. Anyways, it's my house. I grew up in it. Left it to get married. Came back after Blake died.
Must have been hard on you.
Oh, I'm a tough old cod. Now, Claire, she couldn't go out, not even to the market. I went to their house, though, maybe a month after, and Cassie was in her 90s, sitting on the fire escape, playing her toy piano. I packed him up and drove him back here, and we haven't been farther than Peeler Point for going on 10 years. Took Claire 2 years to be able to walk out into the garden.
I still say, go find yourself a handsome young thing.
Who'd want a dried up old lady like me? Good for whiskey, whist, and bending an ear, not much else.
Oh, I don't know. I think you've got some sin left in you.
Things in the muffin tins.
Now, if your grandmother and that man would just come back.
Adam. His name is Adam. Why are you so mean to him? And why are you so mean to Mitch?
I'm not mean.
Nobody's good enough for you.
I want the best for my daughter.
Jesus, Mom! I'm not marrying him. We're just hanging out.
Hanging out is right.
How come you got a sexual revolution and I have to keep my knees together?
There's a hell of a lot more to life than sex.
Don't you think I know that?
I'm not sure what you know. In fact, I'm a little afraid of what you think you know. Finally, I have been waiting for the blueberries.
We didn't find any.
Why were you gone so long?
Oh, Claire, don't start up with me. I'm not Cassie.
You're acting like Cassie.
And you are acting like an ass.
I'm sick of you constantly undermining my authority.
You have no authority over me.
And you have no right to give my daughter Condon's a set a loose example. You go prancing around here, giggling like a little idiot just because somebody with a penis walked into this house.
Cassie is smart enough to choose her own examples. And you are the only person around here who can't deal with the fact that there is a penis in this house.
I want to talk to you.
Oh, good. I want to thank you. Well, not just for these. I appreciate the way you've taken me in. I've been nothing but trouble. I don't know why you haven't thrown me out, but I'm grateful. I wish we could be friends. Well, the truth is, I've always been bedazzled by strong women.
That's for the pipes.
Oh, pipes. You're very wise.
Well, we strong women tend to be. And let me wise you up. You will buy and install those pipes, and then you will leave. You understand?
She doesn't always mean what she says.
This time she does.
Sometimes I really hate her.
Remember that when you have kids.
Do you have kids?
Me?
Weren't you ever married?
Once, during the war.
She died? Like in the Blitz? Oh, God. So sad. Sorry, I ruined your pickup.
Hey, Cassie.
Dad used to push me away, too. Except when there was a photographer in the house. Then it was Blake Wellesley family portrait time. Except he wasn't really a dad at home. He was just a famous person at home.
It won't happen again.
Yeah, right.
Hey, I'm not a famous person.
Then why'd you do it?
She reminded me of someone.
Someone you had an affair with? A married woman?
Very married. To a very powerful and dangerous man.
Did he try and kill you? I mean, are you in danger?
Love endangers us all.
Right there, plain as day, bleached out on my dishcloth, the face of the Virgin. Oh, my gracious.
Hi, Eloise. Hi, Bessie.
Hi, Cassie.
Hey, Miss.
Cassie.
This is Adam.
Morning.
How'd you do?
Ladies.
We're here for some pipes and junk.
Well, you know where they are. If you need any help, just call me.
She's so hard to talk to. Like, she gets all upset. Like, I'm not supposed to have my own life, you know? Madam Denial. Like in the sixth grade when that book came out about Dad screwing all those women.
That was fiction.
See? Madam Denial.
Shouldn't you be buying some of this stuff?
May I handle this, please?
The stupid thing is I don't want to disappoint her.
Then don't.
But it's my life. I'm not a kid. I should be able to make my own decisions.
Make them.
But I don't want to disappoint her.
You can't have it both ways, Cassie. Besides, she won't break.
You don't know Mom.
No black and white?
Color prints and slides.
Oh, but miss, color is for Christmas cards. This is art.
Well, art, we got color prints and slides.
But miss, where can we buy black and white film?
Cassie, run along home. Here.
There must be another store in the environs.
I can't believe this.
Mom, you know, I love you, and I...
Are you going to ground me?
No.
Charlie and Hope Bowers? Mrs. and Miss Wellesley.
How do you do?
Hi.
The Bowers want a room for the weekend.
We were just so lucky he came along. We were going to drive all the way to Kennebunkport.
So your great-grandfather built this house, huh?
That's right, yes. And everything's antique, too. All the quilts come in. And we grind fresh cinnamon for the coffee cake every morning.
Oh, my goodness.
By hand.
I can't wait.
Yeah.
Wait. Where are the pipes?
They didn't have what we need. I ordered them. They should be 3 or 4 weeks.
Charlie, this is wonderful. Oh, what a beautiful tableau. Oh, and such a lovely armoire.
My great-great-grandfather made it for his wife.
Oh,
a wedding gift.
Oh.
So what's the damage per diem?
$90 a night.
Honey, pay the lady.
Oh, right.
I have to use the commode.
Oh, this way. Thank you.
I'm going out to get the luggage.
I'll give you a hand, Charlie.
Oh, my God! A clawfoot tub. It's not an original.
Yes, oh, it's God. An original. It's porcelain. Yes. Oh, I know.
It's gorgeous. Adam, I don't know what to say.
I didn't think you would. This goes. I found it in the attic. And guess what? There's a lot more up there.
I know they're mine.
You paint?
I did. I did.
Hey, leave it.
It's good. Besides, you have a mark there.
I was going to open a gallery coffee house. Impressionism and espresso. Then I met Blake.
What difference did that make?
Compared to what he was working for? Pretty insignificant.
Not if you're into impressionism and espresso.
Are you?
Your handyman.
Oh, you know what I mean.
Does it matter? All right, let's put it this way. You're in a store. The cashier gives you too much change. Keep it?
No, Jill.
Have you ever told a lie? I mean a real lie.
No, why would I?
For convenience, for profit, for fun.
Lying isn't fun.
Then you have not been telling the right lies.
What kind of lies have you been telling?
Gray ones. Can you live with that?
Good, I'm not sensitive about my cooking.
Merely a suggestion. What do you have here?
Stop.
Well, a little cayenne. I could turn this into a Bombay chicken curry beyond description.
A man who can cook. It's a wonder you haven't been snapped up.
Well, I was many times. But my stabs at connubial bliss never lasted too long.
Irreconcilable differences.
Mainly they all yelled at me.
Cassie is dyeing her underwear.
A guest almost fell through.
He's helping me with the groceries first.
Adam's coming on a picnic with me and Mitch to the bluff today.
Honey, you can go on a picnic any time. That step needs fixing and the weather vane. Did you see it? Can you fix it?
But we planned it and everything.
Groceries come first.
Silly bunch of biddies. Yeah.
Coast where the sea is both mother and devil. Now, a pretty young girl lived there, lips the color of the sunset. One day, a ship approached and rocked a skiff. Before she could wink, a young man appeared. A handsome young fellow. The more handsome because he was a stranger. He turned her head, as young men and strangers are apt to do. He lit a fire in her and made her his own. But after he had his way with her, he went his way without her. Alone, she wandered the shore till winter took pity and froze her body round her burning heart. And that's how she looks today. A light to warn sailors from rocky shores. Young girls from stony strangers.
How about that nip? Who's that? I think it's raining.
It certainly is.
Warm, isn't it?
Want to take a walk?
Yeah.
home by one.
You too.
Continued health. I'll fail in that. To your happy degeneration. Oh, I found this t'other day. Amazing, don't you think? Just like a lobster. Except the claw part.
Amos, why am I here?
Beg your pardon?
Why did you ask me here?
Oh, I enjoy your company.
Oh, I'm a pal, a chum, someone to shoot the crap with, huh?
Okay, I'm not young. My thighs look like dimpled waffles. Yours are probably terrific. My upper arms are thinking of following my thighs. But the rest of me is okay. I was not prime, but it's good. And inside, my motor is terrific. And it is all revved up and ready to go, and I want to use it. I don't want to just let it rust away. Right now, those precious lobsters of yours are probably giggling and tickling each other and doing whatever the hell it is that lobsters do.
Ruthie, what are you saying?
Oh, Jesus Christ, on a bicycle, Amos. Do I have to spell it out for you?
You ever think about your parents making love?
Don't make me puke.
I wonder if my mother's ever had an orgasm.
I doubt it. I mean, if she knew how good it felt, why would she be upset at you enjoying yourself?
I don't think she thinks about it like that. I mean, do you think your parents like sex?
I don't think my parents have sex. I think they're too old. Fat.
Old people can have sex, and so can fat people.
Yeah. But old, fat people, you know? Think about it.
No.
You didn't tell her.
I tried.
Cass. She's got to find out sooner or later.
I know.
We have to be prepared for this.
I know.
My parents are not going to be of any help, you know?
I know, I know. I'll tell her tonight. I promise.
Right.
I will.
Cassie has a crush on you.
Andrew.
What about you?
You don't know how hard it's been raising a child alone. Oh, I have Ruth. Oh, Ruth. She's as bad as Cassie. I mean, I don't get any support. I mean, you have to teach a child self-control, how not to get trapped into situations, and not a pleasant world out there. People will rob you of everything you've got. If
what does all this have to do with you having a crush? Join me. Where to?
where'd you go?
Saskatchewan.
You're kidding.
No, I have a cousin there.
I just never thought of you with relatives.
Well, actually, we're partners, my cousin and I. He wanted a new start, so I financed him a little venture. Now we own a lodge near a thriving metropolis called Moose Jaw.
Moose Jaw? Have you ever been there?
Everywhere else.
To Moose Jaw.
Not with all this sand. Famous man who died in an accident a long time ago.
It's a question of loyalty.
To what? His memory?
Yes.
Memory of an unpaid for husband.
I want to set you straight.
Please don't, Claire.
Mom, I have to talk to you.
Adam, I want to clear this up.
Mom, this can't wait.
Evening, Claire. Everybody?
Good night. Good night.
Good night.
Good night. None of your business.
Well, it's none of yours.
Mom.
What?
I graduated.
What?
I graduated.
But you have one more year. Yeah, I don't understand.
No, I took a bunch of tests, equivalency and extra classes. I'm finished with high school.
Oh, well, I don't know what to say.
Yeah, well, that's not all. See, Mitch and me, we're going to New York. Mitch will get a job and I'm gonna do my music and...
Absolutely not.
See, we planned it all out. We're staying with friends.
What friends?
And we met them at a concert.
You met strangers at a concert? You're gonna live with them in New York?
Yes.
No!
I knew you'd do this.
Sweetheart, you're 16 years old. You have no idea what the city is like. You could get hurt.
I'm not gonna get hurt, Mom.
Because you're not going.
You can't stop me,
yes,
Mom.
I can, and go to your room right now.
Mom.
Don't answer me back. Just go.
Mom, don't do this.
Go in your room.
Claire.
Stay out of it, Ruth. Just get in. What are you staring at? Cassie, you have to believe me. This is for your own good. Cassie! Cassie? Cassie!
Claire, let her go.
She could get hurt.
She won't. She'll be back in the morning, I promise you.
Sorry.
It's all right. I'm leaving.
I never thought you... Surprise.
I hope you use some protection.
Cassie. Mother.
Being an adult means being in control of situations and yourself. Was it nice?
That good, huh?
I'm very angry at you.
I'm mad at you, too.
If you want to do music, why don't you study first? UM has a good department and...
Mom, you know I don't want to do it that way.
Oh. You're so young. When will I be old enough to go with your consent?
When you're 35.
Mom. I'll never be able to control my own life unless you let me.
We'll see. We'll see.
I'm gonna leave.
No.
Ruth, no. I was out of line.
Ah, oh, it isn't that. It's just that Amos and I would like our privacy.
But it's your house.
Oh, what's a house? Anyway, I was going to sell it a long time ago, but...
Won't be the same.
It doesn't have to be the same. Anyway, I'll just be over the hill.
Hardly.
So, you're screwing my mother.
To use the idiom?
Screw, fuck, bang, who cares what you call it?
Well, I think she might. I do.
You gonna stick around?
Any objections?
You gonna marry her?
Well, I thought I might work on just sticking around for now. Okay?
Okay.
Thanks.
Just be good to her, I'll kick your butt.
Tea time.
Remember when I've been this relaxed?
Last night. Top of the tree?
Every year.
Your mother's hope chest.
Grandmother's. She gave it to me on my 16th birthday.
Columbus Day fundraiser?
4th of July.
Claire, why not Randolph? He's a good man. He adores you. And you can trust him.
I know, but I just can't see a lifetime with him.
Does it have to be a lifetime?
Supposed to be. I married Blake forever.
And that made you so happy?
Happy enough. I suppose inside, I knew about Blake. But you know, you worked so hard to build a life. And he was so brilliant, exciting. And I knew who I was, what I was. I was Blake Wellesley's wife. And who are you?
I'm here. You know something? I don't know a bloody thing about pipes.
Thank you. How you doing?
Fine.
Do you have any vacancies?
Well, yes.
Are you the owner?
Yes, I'm Claire Wellesley, and this is my daughter.
What if Mitch and me stay at the Y?
Not now. But please, Cassie, show these gentlemen to their rooms. You don't have any luggage.
No, we don't.
Well, this is the Wellesley house. We have antique quilts, and we grind fresh cinnamon for the coffee cake every morning.
You, our handyman, is not who you're looking for.
How old is he?
50.
This man is a con artist, professional liar. He built our company out of millions without batting an eye. Now, you think a man like that would use you as much as he needed and then throw you away when he was finished?
Adam wouldn't do that.
Adam. Who's Adam? And if he doesn't have anything to hide, then why isn't he here? Wait a minute, Julius.
Okay.
You bastard.
I'm so sick of your Ivy League, touchy-feely, psychobabble bullshit. Now, tell me where the fucker is, bitch, or I'll crush your face.
No!
Shut up!
No!
Sir Alex Caxton, please. Yes, I'll hold. Your lives are riding on this, correct? If he hears I'm alive, you are dead. So you will let go of the ladies. Go back to Caxton. Tell him you found nothing. My body washed out to sea, case closed. Or I stay on the line, say hello, Alex, and finish us all. Well?
What about Julius?
Tell him the handyman hit him. And you got away before the police came. Can you hold a second? Who do I say is calling?
Lift him up. Come on.
Get in the car.
A word of advice. Caxton doesn't like loose ends. Watch your backs.
Thanks.
We won't meet again.
But I was drunk and I didn't think. I told them you were here. And then I realized.
Randolph, how in the hell could you... Ugh. Never mind. I don't want to even hear about it. I'm going to bed.
Randolph, your face...
I'm fine. I was worried about you.
You're bleeding.
I'm all right.
Dad, let me take care of you.
Yeah.
I once convinced a man to give me $10 million to buy an island off the southern coast of Madagascar. Fool. Any atlas would have shown him there are no islands off the southern coast of Madagascar. But he was begging for it. The sorriest thing is, though, that within a year I was broke again. A lot of bad luck, bad judgment, and very bad women. Better known as the good life. I've never had to explain. I mean, the women I've known never cared. Why, I didn't have to be worthy.
Just say it.
Yeah, I'm trying, Claire. I'm trying. I've taken a lot of money off a lot of people. Oh, not widows and orphans. But rich people, very rich people, who so desperately wanted to be even richer they couldn't see through the simplest scam. Can't say I haven't enjoyed it. I have, mostly. And I'm not ashamed of my life. It's just that I've never been an honest man. Until now. Good of Randolph to come by to check on you. He's a real handyman. He could fix this place up.
But I like what you've done.
Cosmetics. Fresh coat of paint. You need something more, Claire. Something solid. You're not listening.
Wrong, Ruthie. Lost my allure for you?
Oh, of course not.
Let's get you packed up, then, so we can get back in time for lunch.
Amos, I can't go.
Why not?
It's Claire. I can't leave her alone. And Cassie should leave. Remember the first campaign? All the relatives in the kitchen stuffing envelopes. We had the victory party at your place in Portland. And the two of you ducked out and flew down to New York to finish celebrating. And I was left to pick up the pieces.
You never complained.
It was hard to complain about Blake. So bright. Charm. And that smile. Hey, Claire. Anyway, I was used to picking up after him. I just didn't intend it to be my life's work.
You don't have to stay, Ruth.
No? You mean you've got Cassie?
I mean, I'm not a mess you have to pick up.
I'm glad to hear that, Claire. Don't let history repeat itself. Adam is not Blake. He left to protect us. I know he loves you, and you know it too.
Thank you.
They're old friends. They live in Queens.
I'm not leaving.
I talked to Mitch's parents. We don't want you driving down on his bike. There are two tickets reserved on Monday's Greyhound.
I'm not leaving you here alone, Mom. I'm not staying here alone, sweetheart. Do you understand? I'm not staying here alone. I want you to go to New York. I want you to have a career. I want you to have a life. Please. I want you to do it. Go clean your room before I torch it. Go to New York.
Coffee for you.